Hello everyone, myself Professor P.G.Chitte, working in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In our fifth session, we will discuss branching looping in Java programming. The learning outcomes are, at the end of the session, the students will be able to explain the different types of branching looping with their syntaxes. And they will execute the programs regarding branching and looping. What we will see in this session? First, we will see the short recap of fourth session. After that, we will see what are the different types of branching and looping and the programs based on the branching and looping. In the fourth session, we have discussed the different mathematical functions. After that, we have discussed the different programs based on the mathematical function, like how to calculate the area of triangle and how to calculate the roots of quadratic equation. Now, in this session, we are discussing branching and looping. What are the different types of branching and looping? It consists of if-else statement, for loop statement, and do-while statement. What is mean by if-else statement? The if-else statement consists of, so this is the general syntax for the if-else. If suppose you are having the condition, for example, x less than 0, and suppose it is true, this condition is true, means this statement will be printed, that statement 1 will be printed. Otherwise, the else statement will be printed. This might be a false statement. But if this particular condition is true, means your statement 1 will be printed. Otherwise, else statement 2 will be printed. Here you can see in the figure, it is the algorithm for the if-else statement. If the condition is true, the if code statement will be printed and there will be the exit of the program. Means this statement will be printed. Otherwise, whenever it is false, so else code, that is else statement, will be printed and it will be ended. There will be the exit from the program. So with the help of this, you can solve very simple programs. In the last session, we had discussed regarding the mathematical function, how to calculate the roots of quadratic equation. But we have never checked that the roots are real or not. So in this if-else statement, we will take, first we will check the roots of the quadratic equation. They are real or imaginary, and after that, we will calculate the roots of quadratic equation. We have calculated the roots of quadratic equation, but we don't have checked the roots of quadratic equation. So the problem statement is write a program to check the whether the roots of the quadratic equations are real or imaginary. We are having the quadratic equation and also we are finding out the roots of quadratic equation. This is the formula. We'll go to the program first. Now, roots2 is a class name, public static void main string args is a main statement. X, that is the one variable we have declared. A is equal to 2, B is equal to 10, and C is equal to 4. These are the values for the roots, that is A, B, C. Now, here we had recalled those values, that is A, B, C. Now, we are having the formula like minus B plus or minus under root B square minus 4AC. So we will check that b square minus 4ac value. So here we will first calculate the b square minus 4ac value in the program. So x is equal to, that is capital X is equal to b square minus 4ac that we have declared here. So b square minus 4ac, and after that, after calculation and the storing of this particular value, we are printing that particular value, that is capital X by plus x. So system dot out dot println x is equal to plus x. So with the help of plus x, the calculated value will be printing here. After that, we are checking that the roots are real or not by x less than equal to 0. If suppose this b square minus 4ac value is greater than 0, means the roots are real. Otherwise, if x less than 0, means the roots are imaginary. If x less than is equal to 0, the roots are real. After that only, we can go to the particular roots of the quadratic equation. Suppose the roots are real. After that, so x is equal to minus b plus, for the first root of the equation, minus b plus mat dot square t in the bracket is divided by 2a. So x is equal to b square minus 4ac. So mat dot sqrt, that is under root of b square minus 4ac. So mat dot sqrt, here we have used the one mathematical function. Here will be the calculation for the x1, that is the first root of the quadratic equation. So system dot out dot println is equal to root 1 is equal to plus x1. So plus x1 will be the this particular value, the first root of the value. Here for the quadratic equation for the second root, that is minus b minus mat dot sqrt x divided by 2a. So this is the particular formula. With the help of this, we can calculate the x2. But it is only possible whenever the roots are real. And suppose the roots are imaginary, it will go to the directly to the else statement. It will be printing like imaginary roots when your x is less than 0. Now we will take the output from this program, go to the DOS prompt. In the DOS prompt, my code will be Java C, that is compilation code, roots 2 dot Java, that is my file name, Java C space file name, that is roots 2 dot Java, enter. So Java is a two-step process. After that, you have to interpret that to execute the program. So Java space roots 2, this is a class name. So here the roots are real because we got x greater than equals to 0, greater than 0, that is x is equal to 68. That's why there is a printing of the particular statement that x, the roots are real. After that only there will be the calculation of root 1 and root 2. So this is the very simple program regarding the if-else statement. Now again we will move to the PPT. Now nested if-else. In the if-else, only we have checked that if-else statement. Now what is meant by nested if-else statement? If suppose there are the more than one condition. Now what is the general syntax for the nested if-else? If suppose your condition 1, in the if condition, if the condition 1 is true, your statement 1 will be printed and everything will be stopped. There will be the exit of the program. But if suppose your condition 1 will be wrong, it will go to the else if statement, that is if else statement. The condition 2 will be checked. And suppose this is true, it will go to the statement 2 and it will be printed because this is the true statement. And after that, there will be the exit of the program. If suppose your condition 2 is false, means it will go to the else statement, or it will go to the condition 3. If suppose your condition 3 is true, means your statement 3 will be printed because this is a true condition. And if suppose your condition 1, condition 2, condition 3 is false, it will go to the directly to the else statement and your statement 4 will be printed. We'll see the algorithm for the nested if-else. Here, after starting the program, it will go to the if condition. If suppose it is true, the statement after if will be printed and it will be the exit of the program. Otherwise, if it is false, it will go to the nested if condition and the true statement will be printed. It will go to the after if statement, that will be printed and it will go to the exit. Again, if suppose it is false, directly it will go to the else statement. So here there are the only one else if statement. Here we are having the two else if statement. Condition 1, condition 2 and condition 3 are the if statement. If suppose these are false, the else statement will be printed directly because these are false. Here the two else if statement, one is suppose it is true, there will be the printing of this particular statement, it will be the exit of the program. If suppose the if statement is false, it will go to the nested if else statement, and if it is supposed true, it will be the directly printing and that will be the exit. But if it is supposed both are false, it will directly go to the else if statement and there will be the exit of the program. Now you are having very simple question. What is the difference between else if statement and if statement? Just think for this question. Now we take Win's simple program regarding the else if statement. Write the program to check whether the student is passed with the distinction or the fail with the help of following conditions. you are having the following conditions. So as we have discussed the syntax for the nested if else, first the p is 65 here we have provided. So we have to print that particular percentage obtained is 65. Now first, if suppose p is greater than 70, if suppose p is greater than 70, this is true value, means the grade is equal to distinction, that will be printed. But if suppose this is false, else if statement it will go through. So that is, if suppose percentage is between 16 to 70, if suppose this is true, means your grade is equal to first class, this statement will be printed. Otherwise it will go to the again the else if statement, that is our third condition, that is the percentage is between 50 to 60, so that will be the second class if it is true. But if suppose these three conditions are false, it will go to the directly to the grade is equal to fail. Now we will check the output here. We have provided the if statement, else if statement, also the else statement. We will go to the directly execution of the program. Now, so Java C space the name of the file, that is marks.java, enter. For the execution of a program, Java space marks, my class name. So we have provided the percentage as a 65. So the grade will be the first class. So this is the nested if else program. We'll go to the PPT here. These are the references. Thank you.